Hi everyone, my name is Sergio. Hello. This is my very first time performing here. If this is anything like the night I lost my virginity, tonight might be a little awkward and uncomfortable, but I will try my best not to finish early. And I promise to keep my eyes open this time. I am really excited to be here tonight. I actually got my hair done. Do you like it? It's called the Mr. Clean Chic. Now, you know what's scary about doing stand-up? The risk of seeing one of your exes in the audience. I am totally okay running into my exes with my car, which is why I was fired by Lyft. And strangely hired by Uber. Yes, I tell you. I know you're looking at me and you're wondering, is he? Is he not? You're not quite sure what side of the fence I'm on. Your suspicions are correct. I'm an immigrant. And I'm here to take your jobs. Porque todos ustedes son un montón de puta que no quieren trabajar. In English, that means I'm really happy to be here. And in case you're wondering, I am not part of MS-13. I am not. Did you know that MS stands for Mara Salvatrucha? Yeah, that is the best drag queen name ever. If I was a drag queen, my name would be Ain't No Nicole Smith. I was born in Central America. No, not Ohio. I was born in Costa Rica or Nicaragua. It depends on who you ask. My mom says I was born in Costa Rica. My birth certificate says I was born in Nicaragua, which confirms my suspicions. I don't think my mom was there when I was born. My mom gave birth to 6 children that she knows about. Yeah. And she is proof you can drink and do drugs during pregnancy. It turned out okay. I was born a healthy baby boy. I weighed 9.5 pounds at birth. Yeah. Turns out I was just bloated from all the margaritas. Now, Latino men don't get any credit for boosting the economy with our cologne purchases. As some of you know, you can smell a Latino from a block away. And you can smell him for 2 blocks after he left. We love cologne so much, we have a saying in Spanish. Por si me besa, por si me abraza, por si se pasa. Translation, in case we kiss, in case we hug, in case we go too far. We always go too far. I have enough cousins for 2 baseball teams. And I have 17 nieces and nephews. Yes, and 4 great-nephews. Yeah, I am the only one in my family without children. I don't want to worry about the baby weight. So I have my tubes tied. Now, we immigrate to this country because we want a better life. We just want to work. Give us a job, whatever it is, we'll do it. We'll even do the jobs you don't want to do. Hand jobs, blow jobs. Now, with all these great jobs available, you can imagine my parents' disappointment when I came out to them as a comic. Now, once people find out I'm a comic, they want me to tell jokes right away. I'm not a gumball machine. You can't just put a quarter in me and I tell jokes. However, I will accept $20 bills. Or sex as payment. By the way, no woman has taken me up on this offer. Women need to feel safe before they have sex with you. Yes. Which is why I only have sex with men. Actually, I'm taking a break from straight men right now. They get too attached. Once they taste this home cooking, they don't want to eat out. And the internal struggle is tough. They're worried they might be gay because they enjoy sex with a man. They're all emotional if I don't call them the day after. Yeah, gay men have it so easy. Eye contact is followed up with a blowjob. Blowjobs are a polite way of saying, hello, nice to meet you. You shake hands and all right, I'll leave you with this last bit. I see some of you have been there. I'll leave you with this last bit. I recently ran into my high school girlfriend and the first words out of her mouth, is it my fault you're gay? And I was like, no, you didn't turn me gay. Your brother did. All right, you guys, my name is Sergio. Thank you.